Bono on gender inequality. And this is, I'm looking at an article on rollingstone.com. And this is an article based on something that a piece that Bono himself wrote, an op-ed that he wrote for Time. And I'm going to leave links to both of them. I prefer the Rolling Stone one. Anyway, poverty is sexist. And this is what Bono says. Men can't step back and leave it to women alone to clean up the mess we've made, U2 singer writes. Well, poverty is sexist. It's if you look throughout the Western world, who are the poorest people of all? And they are, of course, the homeless. And the overwhelming majority of homeless people are men. And you can bet your bottom dollar if they were women, far mountains would move. Political mountains would move. And I'd be amazed if Bono himself wasn't on the case. Now, he seems to concentrate on things in the third world and developing countries, which is his business. But maybe someone should tell him sometime that charity begins at home. Now, what he's actually talking about here, which I'm going to get onto in a moment, is girls' education in developing countries throughout the world. But he doesn't appear to have any interest in boys' education, which is why I've called him what I've called him. Anyway, he says, men can't step back and leave it to women alone to clean up the mess we've made. What mess is he talking about? The buildings, the bridges, the jumbo jets, the computer technology, and practically everything you can think of that's invented. Here he goes, a male feminist, attacking men. And he says we, he includes himself, but of course, he's not really attacking himself. And in the Time article, he starts off by declaring that he's not a masochist. Well, I'd say that he's a narcissist. Now, you see, he's attacking other men, and he's grandstanding, he's posing, he's virtue signaling, and he's putting himself, which of course he is, in a far superior position to the average male. It is the classic man who's part of the, he's making me go hoarse. It's a question of, I'm all right, Jack, which he is, of course. He's stinking rich and world famous. He has lots of power. He has everything he wants. And he gets into that position of power. And then he attacks his own gender. Disgusting. Doesn't matter what you think of his music. He should get out of politics and stick to music. I'm even more angry with him now because he's making me lose my voice. Bono penned an op-ed for Time urging action from men, especially world leaders and those in other positions of power, to reduce gender inequality. Yet they should do it right throughout the Western world and stop all the inequality that men and boys face. And when it comes to boys, particularly the discrimination they face in the education system. And this guy, Bono, is talking about the education of girls and girls only in other countries. Charity begins at home. Anyway, men can't step back and leave it to women to clean up the mess we've made and are still making. Misogyny, violence and poverty are problems we can't solve at half strength, which is the way we've been operating for a few millennia now. It's sick. Oh, Jesus God. This reminds me of all the women that, well, I used to on the TV and I'd watch these man-bashing daytime debate shows, and every now and then a woman would come up with a standard. She'd say something sexist and she'd be questioned on it, sexist against men. And then she'd say, they've been doing it to us for thousands of years. It's our turn to do it to them. He sounds as pathetic as that. He talks about misogyny. Why does he take care of his own gender and look into misandry, the hatred of men? And as far as violence is concerned, most violence is committed against men. As far as poverty is concerned, there's no evidence that I've ever seen that women in the countries he deals with face worse poverty than the men. Bono credits his wife Ali and two daughters, Eve and Jordan, with teaching him about sexism and the extent of the gender gap in education and income. Well, the gender gap in education throughout the Western world is women doing more better in universities than men. Certainly there are more women in universities than men. What kind of degrees they're taking is another matter. And girls are outperforming boys in school and nothing is being done to stop it. In fact, more and more emphasis continues to be put on girls' education. As far as income is concerned, well, we all know that the gender pay gap throughout the Western world has nothing to do with discrimination. Anyway, he says that Jordan reminds me there is nowhere on earth where women have the same opportunity as men. Then he repeats, nowhere. Absolute rubbish. Not only do they have the same opportunities, they are now being given privileges. There are all sorts of women-only managerial courses and women-only promotion schemes, women-only quotas, etc., etc. Anyway, Bono says, which has something to do with the fact that around the world there are 130 million girls who are not in school. I'd love to know where he got that statistic from, because I'm going to put a link to this Rolling Stone article, plus a link to the original article that was penned just in January this year, that Bono wrote for Time. And I'm also going to stick a link to an advert here on YouTube made by UBS about closing the gender gap. And that also is about girls' education. And they claim that it's not 130 million girls who are not in school. Their figures are 62 million. Now, UBS, for those of you who don't know, they're a Swiss financial organization, investment organization, I suppose, part of the banking industry. And I've noticed in recent years that loads of these big banks and banking institutions and organizations and people to do with the banks are getting involved in this equality business, because that's what it has become. And I'll name a few: American Express, Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan Chase & Co., it's a Turkish bank I've just forgotten the name of, Barclays Bank, of course, finances or partly finances the He for She campaign, which Emma Watson shamelessly promotes, and that's for the United Nations. So I'm just going to have a look at the United Nations, actually. Here we go. This took a minute to find. United Nations Girls Education Initiative. And as far as I'm aware, there's no equivalent for boys. And the organization that's part of this, they're having a meeting in 2019, just next year, in Canada. And it's going to be the biggest in the world. And it's just women this, women that, girls the other. And I would be amazed if Justin Trudeau doesn't turn up at this thing. And I should point out that he also is down on record as stating that poverty is to do with gender. In fact, he used the exact same words as Bono: poverty is sexist. And as Trudeau has just declared that the issue that's foremost in the minds of the Canadian people is that they want more immigrants in the country, which is absolute rubbish. I've seen no evidence of that whatsoever. Bono is also very keen on refugees as well. And he likes them to be called refugees. I believe he addressed an Italian crowd in Turin about them. And he's down on record as saying that they shouldn't be called immigrants, that they should be referred to as refugees. And I've seen articles on this in the past, with the United Nations claiming that the vast majority of these people flooding into Italy are refugees. They're not. I've seen evidence that suggests that over 98% of them are economic migrants, and they have no business being in Europe, and most of us here don't want them. They bring all their troubles with them. Anyway, regarding banking activity and the bankers being so interested in this equality business, I'm wondering, is it out of largesse? Is it, are banks philanthropic all of a sudden? Have they become philanthropists? They're not exactly known for it. The whole idea of being a bank is to make as much money as you possibly can. Now, it has been suggested to me in the past that they're doing this as sort of, because they've got such a bad reputation these days, that they're doing it for PR purposes and just trying to look good. A cynic might think that the reason that so many banks are investing in girls' education and want to see girls educated all over the world is because they then go into the workplace where they're prepared to work for less money, of course, and they open bank accounts and they then pay taxes. So it's, that's just cynical me. Anyway, denying girls what an education offers, Bono says, a fair shot, a path out of poverty, means that women can work the land but can't own it. They can earn the money but can't bank it, he continues. This is why poverty is sexist, he explains. Bono points to research indicating that reducing and eventually eliminating the global gender gap in education is both a victory for equality and for economic growth, Banks. The research is clear that funding girls' education is a charity, but investment, Banks, and the returns are transformational for the Banks. He writes, well, he's not mentioned the Banks, I am. When you invest in girls' Banks and women, Banks, they rise and they lift their families, their communities, their economies, Banks, and countries along with them. Yeah, along with fucking debt. Anyway, final paragraph. He says that eliminating the gender gap in education will not eliminate sexism. Well, someone needs to educate Bono not to be sexist against his own gender. And he acknowledges that sexism remains rampant, conscious, and unconscious. Well, he seems to have an unconscious sort of sexism about him. Anyway, I regard him as being the gender equivalent of an Uncle Tom. And if anyone can think of a way of putting that to apply to these male feminists, then please leave your comments in the comments section. Thank you.